Hey everybody, this is Max Adler, and you're watching GLEE'yond the Marquee.
I'm Allison here for Beyond the Marquee. We're in downtown LA at the awesome City Hearts Theater, which is a great organization encouraging inner city kids to get involved and experience the arts. And today we had an awesome show with one of the stars of Glee, Max Adler.
I hereby ban all cheerleaders except for Clara, and you will be serving 1 year of detention.
Oh, Max!
I hope that teaches you a lesson.
Hi, Max, how are you?
I'm doing great. I just saw a phenomenal show, so couldn't be better.
So talk to us a little bit, just explain your involvement with City Hearts and how this whole awesome show came to be.
I went to an event for City Hearts because a friend of mine had introduced me to Sherry and Bob Jason, who started it and were public defenders and have been running City Hearts for 25 plus years now. And I talked to a lot of the kids who had taken the classes and who were involved with the schools, and I was so touched by their stories because a lot of them just straight out told me that they would have been in a lot of trouble and they would have kind of turned to the streets and to the drugs or do whatever they had to do for money. But once they got involved with the arts, it built a self-esteem in them and it gave them dreams and hope and goals. And I was just so moved, and so I've started the Max's ABC initiative, and so far we've raised close to $16,000, and this money just keeps the program going. It allows for shows like this to be put on, to rent the space, to get the props, to do the t-shirts, and it's just so magical to me because I feel like these kids now are so bonded at such a young age that they've gone through this experience together, and it's people from all walks of life that have now joined together for a common goal.
So what I wanted to talk about was the show. It was incredible. The kids wrote it, mm-hmm. Is that right? Mm-hmm. And they acted it out, they put it on themselves, yes. And we had all kinds of stuff going on. We had some zombies, we had the cafeteria,
yep.
Ladies,
we had the cheerleaders, the geeks who love Star Wars, but yeah, it's phenomenal because they put so much time into it. It's been, 4 months at least, multiple days a week for hours on end. And yeah, they wrote it based on characters that they had created in improv activities. So it's all from them. And again, it's stimulating creativity. They're not stealing thoughts from anyone. I mean, this is all just original creative energy.
Will you go to the Star Wars convention with us?
Whatever major you get.
And what was amazing was that not only were there great performances, but the messages in there about, breaking down the stereotypes and seeing past the uniforms and the cheer costumes as people to people. The fact that they wrote that and understand that and can convey that is so powerful. And the fact that so many parents were in the audience that now maybe have expanded their mind or changed their perspective on things because of what their kids wrote. So it's just such an amazing cycle.
Will you get out of it? Do you know how amazing this feels? I've heard of kids that are in school kind of dying. They kill themselves because they're scared.
And the parents are so proud and they're going to go talk about it and the message will just spread on their level as well as from the kids.
Right. One night, with a theater here can change hundreds of lives. And so, yeah, it's just imagine if theaters all over the city and then the state and then the country were doing this, how the world would change. And what's really magical for me is that my character on Glee has impacted quite a few people, and they'll send me letters or talk to me when they see me at these events and share their stories of how the media and the stories and the character can really change their minds and their way of thinking about themselves. So it's super powerful. It really is.
And speaking of Glee, last night was a really intense episode where your character specifically was going through a lot that was coming from this issue of bullying.
I mean, yeah, my character basically attempts suicide because he's so cornered by his peers into thinking that who he is and what he believes is wrong.
Knowing how dense and how serious the idea that Karofsky was going to commit suicide, it was daunting because how do you do that on Glee?
I almost can't think of a more touchy topic than suicide, really.
Shooting that suicide scene was the most intense experience on set I've ever had. I couldn't sleep after shooting it. I was very, very affected and very moved.
Can I come in?
And that's the message that this play is showing, is that you can be whoever you want to be and express yourself freely and be who you are without worrying about how everybody else perceives you and thinks about you.
I actually like Star Wars.
You do too?
Yeah.
And I think the really important thing for people to learn is that who they are is not wrong. And I think that society kind of sometimes corners people and tries to peg them in certain roles and teach them that who they are is wrong and that they don't belong here. And I think that's where it all starts with the depression, which leads to the contemplating suicide. So if we stop that thought now and show them that they can be who they are freely without concern, and that people will accept you and love you for who you are without any judgment, then, you know, if we can change some lives and change people's minds, then we've done our job, you know. And kudos and credit to Sherry and Bob Jason and everybody involved and Rebecca for putting so much time and so much effort into helping these kids put on the show. I mean, she was there 10 hours a week at least, you know, just giving her heart and soul and blood, sweat, and tears to make a difference single-handedly, you know, in these kids' lives. And they're really saving lives. So it's just been such a pleasure, such an honor. And if there's another show for City Hearts, everybody should come check it out because it's not to be missed.
Well, thank you again so much for your time, and we really appreciate everything you're doing. Thanks so much.
I appreciate it. Hey everybody, this is Max Adler, and you're watching GLEE'yond the Marquee.
Yeah, I like it. I like it. It is clever. I always like a play on words. A good pun's always appreciated.
This has been a Studio 23 production.